chosen this evening the color ivory. This suit conveys military-inspired regality without compromising stylish civilian details like soft fabric and a fluid drape. The jacket has an even collar and structured lines that create a crisp silhouette. The pants have double box pleats and a slightly fuller leg. Some of Dangerous C's honors include becoming Mr. Capital City Elite 2000, Mr. Ohio EOY 2002, and Mr. Iowa Continental 2002. He says his hobbies include many things: singing, dancing, entertaining on stage. He loves to talk. He loves meeting new people and to travel. He says, my special interests are as follows. I love working with neglected people, I hope. And I also like talking to teens about sexuality issues. He attended the New York School of Performing Arts, where he studied jazz, contemporary, and modern dance. He has also studied applied vocals and theater. He says, my future goal is to open a gay youth center to help teens cope with their sexuality. My current goal is to become the next Mr. Gay Indiana All-American. His platform, if chosen to be Mr. Gay Indiana, is to push forward for preliminaries. He would attend every contest so that he may promote it. He would also like to have a benefit show for the research for AIDS and breast cancer. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 4, Dangerous D. All right. Lots of question. You know the drill. Okay. Jerry Springer show calls and asks you to appear on the show. The topic is miracle cure for homosexuality. As Mr. Gay Indiana, do you go? Why or why not? Okay, once again, that's a tough one. The Jerry Springer show calls and asks you to appear on the show. The topic is miracle cure for homosexuality. As Mr. Gay Indiana, do you go? Why or why not?
Thank you, Paul. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and my most distinguished panel of judges. In reference to the question, no, I would not appear on the Jerry Springer Show as Mr. Gay Indiana, because Mr. Indiana is set on standards. And to me, being gay is set on standards. And if you're gonna go on a TV show to set yourself up to be derogatorized, then you know better than the person that's on the TV show. Thank you very much and have a wonderful day.
Thank you. Let you all know there are 7 preliminary pageants to Miss Gay Indiana 2002. 3 have already been held and four more are scheduled. Miss Gay Crossroads will be June 15th. Tara Hope, June 7th. And we will also have Miss Elegance and Miss Muncie. The winner and first runner-ups from these pageants will compete for Miss Gay Indiana, along with the representatives from the Miss Gay Indianapolis, Southern Cities, and Circle City pageants. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, please welcome to the stage, in fashion modeling, contestant number 5, Dillon. Dillon is modeling a 3/4 length gold pony hair jacket, which is the latest in men's runway styles for the season.
Come on, Dillon!
He has accessorized his ensemble with matching alligator skin, belt, and shoes. Some of his sponsors this evening include Mackenzie Bryant, Rich Guerrero, Romeo Productions, Yellow Rose Productions, Eric McNamara, Melissa Stone, Bill Thomas, Leslie Ryan, McIntyre Enterprises, and his loving parents. My greatest accomplishment in my lifetime would be staying level-headed, healthy, being a young gay man in today's society. Some of his special training includes cheerleading and choir throughout high school. Mr. Gay Indiana All-American, to become Mr. Gay All-American, and to finish his education. He says that my platform for the year, if chosen to be Mr. Gay Indiana, is to help make Mr. Gay Indiana the largest and finest contest before the end of his reign. He says, I would also like to help prevent hate crimes and promote tolerance among different lifestyles and race. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, contestant number 5, Dillon. What would be your advice? Once again, a 17-year-old comes to you for advice. He wants to come out to his parents and let them know about his sexuality. What would be your advice?
Thank you, Cole. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and my distinguished panel of judges. For your conviction again, I'm contestant number 5, Dillon. The question brought to me today was, a 17-year-old person wanted to come out to his parents. What would be my advice? My advice to that person would be wait till you know it in your heart and your mind before you're ready, because coming out to your parents is going to be the hardest thing you do in life. You risk the fact of possibly losing them or maybe anything better as a friend, like I did my mother when I came out to her. Thank you.
What do you think of those fashions? All right, they really worked hard tonight. Okay, y'all ready to see some good entertainment? Oh, come on, y'all wanna see some entertainment? All right, keep the applause going, and welcome to the stage, Mr. Gay All-American, 2001, from Orlando, Florida, Ryan Davis.
Oh. Davis. He's good looking too, boy, that helps. I wish she was competing in swimwear. No, I didn't get, oh, you got, I was busy, I didn't get to see it, that figures. All right, if you would, please give a big thunderous round of applause and welcome to the stage your current reigning Miss Gay Indiana 2001, Erica Cartier. Something new that we're doing. For those of you who don't know, this is, as the sign says up there, the 17th Mr. Gay Indiana. So we're very proud that we've been around for 17 years. So please give it up real quick for Mr. Cleo Brasher and James Wilson. And what tonight is kind of a celebration about what we do. So what I'd like to do real quick before we start this video is to bring this gentleman out to the stage. He is celebrating his 10 years of winning the title of Mr. Gay Indiana back in 1992. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Jamie Christian as we share with you his crowning moment 10 years ago.
Thank you.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you would, now welcome to the stage on his 10-year anniversary, Mr. Gay Indiana 1992, Jamie Christian.
No! Cherokee, you have some people blocked in. Please move your vehicle. That's a gray Jeep Cherokee. Go ahead, James.
Thank you. If you would, please put your hands back together and give a big, thunderous round of applause for your Miss Gay Indiana from 2000, the one-name sensation, Caress.
When I was young, I used to dream of going. Really?
for Perez. All right, and now, if you would, please welcome to the stage the man of the hour this evening, the reason we are all here. Please welcome Mr. Gay Indiana 2001, Mr. Kole Michaels.
Thank you.
Alright. Well, while they're clearing the stage, I did notice there's a few people out there I'd like to acknowledge. I know they're out there somewhere. The current reigning Miss Gay Indianapolis, Tanya Bear Rogers, where are you at? Stand up, she's over there. Alright. Also, Miss Gay Circle City's out in the house, Mackenzie Bryant. She's out there somewhere. They are both qualified to compete for Miss Gay Indiana. Alright. Are you all ready to see some guys in swimsuits? Well, that didn't sound convincing. I thought we were in a gay club. Y'all want to see some guys in some swimsuits? Well, before we do that, we have somebody else to see in a swimsuit. And I'm sure she's going to knock your socks off. Please welcome to the stage as she's going to take over for the next portion of competition. Please welcome Miss Vicky St. James.
Swimwear. Bet you I'd have won. The rest of the girls aren't wearing two pieces. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, in swimwear, the judges are not specifically looking for rippling muscles, although they certainly wouldn't hurt. However, a toned body is the key here. The contestant's swimsuit should fit and flatter their own body and skin color. Their modeling ability and stage presence will be judged as well. Our swimwear category is worth 150 points per judge. And at this time, all the judges there, we're gonna go ahead with contestant number one, Rasean Montrese. Rasean's swimwear is provided by Cornell Hughes. It is a Cornell Hughes original. The cotton blend for top and bottom give the illusion of a strictly poolside person. And as you've seen, ladies and gentlemen, this outfit has a surprise. The trunks are made of nylon netting to let the water in and keep Rasean from coming out. Don't hold back, baby. Rasean is 21, finally. He's 5'8", 945 pounds with brown eyes and black hair. His sponsors this evening are Cornell Hughes, Mr. Kieber Wyatt, Mr. Anthony Payne, and Paypon, is that right? And Ms. Mocha Montrese. He's currently a full-time student at Indiana University studying computer science, working with the family catering company. He lists his community involvement, current and past, as a resident assistant at Indiana University, helping students with the transition from home to college life. Also volunteers in his high school music department. You ready, judges? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Rasean Montrese. Contestant number two in swimwear competition, Jim Jones. Jim is wearing an original design created and tailored just for him by Joe Marr Creative Fashions of Crown Point, Indiana. His suit is made of 100% cotton jungle print that was tailored in true ape man fashion. The raised front and lowered rear cover just enough to keep the goods hidden and the onlookers fantasizing. Oh. The suit also features two rawhide drawstrings. Not rawhide. Oh. Rawhide. Attaching and tying. lying at the size and a black nylon and lacquer bikini to keep him legal when splashing around in the pool or at the beach. Please note the tailor went to the great lengths to ensure that the elephant was properly placed on the suit. Just where you would expect the trunk to be. The necklace around Jim's neck is made of white tucker beads and etched bamboo. It complements the jungle theme of the suit and is indicative of surfer wear as well. The sunglasses atop Jim's head are also a jungle print and pose, but for one question, who's that man beneath those foster grants? The overall ensemble creates a mood of fun and festiveness with a threat of animal passion lurking in the groin. Damn, you should write for Dirty Magazine, sweetheart. You got a little off there. I'm gonna have to go check myself. I think I starched my panties. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number two, Jim Jones. An interesting note how you guys are tabulating. My father went to Bible college with the real Jim Jones. Not in that classy, a woman sucking down a long neck. Yeah. Meet me out back, I'll be at the truck. You kids get back in this trailer right this minute. Are we ready, judges?
No big necks in the pool!
You leave my babies alone. I don't want to have it with you. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant free in swimsuit competition, Ryan Matthews. Ryan is modeling a highly contemporary box cut swimsuit designed by Robin Picone. Swimsuit is dominated by robin egg blue and features stripes of varying width. A variety of colors, including many shades of blue, black, yellow, and lavender, accent the suit, giving it a fun and trendy look. Ryan was Mr. Encompass 2002. He lists his hobby as severe storm weather spotting and tornado chasing. Ooh, you're a brave man. Ryan is 28 years old, 6'3 and 170 pounds, with blue eyes and brown hair. His sponsors this evening are Encompass Nightclub and Lounge. He's a self-employed visual designer, choreographer, and music instructor for competitive marching band, drum and bugle corps, and color guard. How are we doing, judges? Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number three in the competition, Ryan Matthews. Okay, we're ready for contestant number four, Dangerous D. Has chosen a classic mid-cut cobalt tailored trunk. This trunk is a snug mid-cut silhouette that sits low on the waist, and it eliminates Dangerous's negatives and accentuates his positives.
Dangerous D is 27, 6'1, 195 pounds with brown eyes and black hair. He obviously owns a copy of Buns of Steel. Trust me, I slapped on him earlier. Forget your copy. He lists his greatest accomplishment as becoming a father because it made him become a responsible man.
All right, Poppy. Number 5, Dillon. Dillon is 23, 5'10", 155 pounds. Shut your legs, girl. We're getting feedback. Dillon's promoter and sponsors are Mackenzie Bryant, Rich Guerrero, and Romeo Productions. Yellow Rose Productions, Eric McManera, McIntyre Enterprise, Melissa Stone, Bill Thomas, Leslie Ryan, and of course, his loving parents. He is employed at Chili's Restaurant and a rotating cast member at Club Millennium Nightclub. Ladies, gentlemen, judges, for your consideration in swimwear competition, contestant number 5, Dillon. My baby brother, turn off the bright lights. We don't want to see the makeup. Please welcome to the stage. He was your Mr. Gay Indiana 1993, Mr. James Randall.
Thank Jane. Damn, now I know how she can afford that rack. DJ, can I have a thank you? Hey, Daddy. Without any further ado, please help me welcome to the stage. He was your Mr. Gay Indiana in 1995. Please welcome to the stage in all of his butchness. My baby brother, Jeff Hoover. We will have 14 contestants competing, all from Indiana. There she is, all of her loveliness. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please let me welcome to the stage. Y'all ready? All right, baby. She is your current reigning Miss Gay Indiana. Please welcome to the stage, Erica Cartier! Come on, folks, give it up for her!
Love the first sight. You got a magic ball that I can't.
guys, Erica Cartier.